2014 prophecies, God spoke to me that there are evil covenants that were made with the land, evil blood covenants that were made with the land of Kenya, or were made with the soil of Kenya. And they have made the nation of Kenya to be under bondage by our ancestors. So the 57 years bloodshed that was shed in the nation, it has to be broken. The Bible says in Hosea 4:6, my people perished due to lack of knowledge. And because we have rejected knowledge, God also has rejected us as priests. God showed me a vision when there was bloodshed from Westgate to Mkeketoni through terror attacks. God showed me that I was crying for this nation, and I was sobbing for this nation because of the bloodshed that has been going on. The enemy has been shedding blood through terror. And when God showed me this vision, he showed me I was with some priests in the nation. And I tried to tell these priests. These priests asked me, why are you crying and sobbing? I told them, I'm crying and sobbing because of our nation, because of the way the enemy has continued shedding blood in this nation. And I told them, do you know there is a prophetic word that God sent in 2009 that we need to act upon it so that this bloodshed can come to an end? And they could not understand. They started arguing with me, asking me, who are you? Who is your spiritual father? Where have you come from? And as we were arguing about this prophecy, in adjacent, the powers of darkness were laughing at us, the priests, and at the Church of Kenya, because we cannot understand, we don't know what we need to do for the bloodshed to come to an end. And they say they have a legal ground to shed more blood. So all what we are suffering is attached to the prophetic word that God said. We have to actualize the prophetic word, this prophetic word that God said. God revealed to me that the blood of innocent people have reached heaven. And when the blood of innocent blood that has been shed in the nation of Kenya has reached heaven, it means when it goes, there's an accusation in the throne room of God over this nation. You remember Genesis 4:10, where when Cain killed his brother Abel, and God asked Cain, what have you done? The blood of your brother is crying to me from the ground. So there's an accusation against this nation of innocent blood, and because we have not repented, so there's so much groaning. The government of Kenya is groaning. The counties are groaning. The land of Kenya is groaning. Families are groaning. Businesses are groaning. Education sector is groaning. All the sectors in the nation of Kenya are groaning, because what is coming from the realm of the spirit, coming down in the physical, is groaning. So we need to repent. So see the prophetic documentary. I've talked about blood issues are very complicated. See the way out of current crisis facing the nation of Kenya. So we need to repent the bloodshed.
What are some of the consequences of bloodshed in the nation?
Blood issues are very complicated. And anytime the enemy manages to raise a satanic blood altar in the nation through murder, tribal crashes, terror attacks, plane crash, flood, and killings and murders in the nation, and it is not dealt with or it is not repented, it resorts to emptiness and desolation. After emptiness and desolation, what happens? We see famine in the land, physical and spiritual famine. And now the famine in the nation has been extended even into our pocket. We have financial famine in the nation of Kenya. A good example in the Bible, it's the time the sons of Jacob wanted to kill his brother Joseph, and they decided to slaughter a goat and put blood on the coat of many colors and go cheat the father that they have killed the brother. Once the blood came down in the ground, it brought famine. And later we can see the sons of Jacob going down to Egypt to look for food because their land was suffering famine. And anytime the voices of innocent blood are speaking in the land and they are not repented and they are not dealt with, it brings groaning. That is why we can see our nation, everything is groaning. The government is groaning. The counties are groaning. The families are groaning. Institutions are groaning. Everything in Kenya is groaning. So we need to repent the sins of bloodshed that has been shed in the last 57 years in our land.